He's gone. He must have taken off as soon as he realized we were onto him.
Yeah, gone, almost.
What's on your mind?
Well, here's the thing. We know who you are. You are life. You give a second chance to those that have died before their time, and we know who Jack is.
My opposite. Choice adjective excluded.
Right. He relives days to ensure that those victims once again die.
Okay, so we know that.
Here's my best guess. The next time that your day restarts, our friend Jack Harper will make his return, because it's clear why he came to the morgue 2 months ago. His work is undone. He came to find his opposite.
And stop me.
Lindsay, I know it's like 6 in the morning, but I had to call and say one
5:15. I'm getting freaking married today, True. Can you believe that?
Still doesn't mean I'm gonna pick up the phone.
Oh my God. Oh, and I also noticed you RSVP plus one, so who you bringing? All right, never mind. I'll just call you later. Bye.
I've driven women to drink.
Driven women to other women.
But I have never driven a woman to the altar within a month of dumping.
Look, here's the thing. I love Lindsay, but she's never been very good at being alone.
Bluey, you know? She's undependable, unreliable. But ever since this Randall guy, I have decided that I'm gonna be a better man. You know, there's someone I can be proud of, someone you can be proud of. A new leaf, so to speak.
A new leaf?
Well, yeah, I'm a young guy. Never too late to change your spots.
Speaking of sudden character transformations, any luck finding Jack?
No, nothing. I scoured the town just like you asked. I went to bars, strip joints.
About that new leaf.
Pacing myself. But I'll tell you who I've run into lately. Luke. So, you've been avoiding him.
Here's the thing. The last time I spoke to Luke, I promised him I'd tell him about me.
Oh.
But as long as I don't tell him, I can still have hope for us. Because I know that as soon as I do, I won't even have that.
Yeah, maybe. But maybe not. Well, see, the point is that you will never know unless you try. And if I could turn a new leaf, anyone can. I gotta go, Wonder Woman.
Bye.
Hey, I hope I'm not interrupting.
No, come here. Watch this. Say it's still cooking. The photo sits in the developer and the chemicals draw out the image. Just give it a couple more seconds. And it's an old role. I never developed it.
She looks familiar.
Yeah. Ex-girlfriend.
Sounds complicated.
It is. Just like her.
Hey, I'm sorry if you feel like I've been avoiding you.
Well, I'm sorry, too. Mainly because you're so damn good at it. Look, maybe heart-to-hearts aren't your thing, and that's fine. There's no law that says you have to explain any
more
to anyone.
Tonight?
Tonight?
Yes, come to Lindsay's wedding with me, and I will explain everything.
Semi-formal, right?
I'll see you at 6. Oh, but hey, Luke, just remember, she is complicated.
Right.
Harrison. Jack, the hell are you doing here?
Came to see a friend.
Great. You let me know when he shows up.
Look. I know True wants you to think I'm the enemy. I'm not. Your sister and I, we see things differently, that's all.
Right. She saves people and you kill them.
I'm not a killer. Straight up, when a bullet gets shot into a man's chest, I don't pull the trigger. When a drunk driver takes out a family of four, I'm not behind the wheel.
But when those people ask for my sister's help, you're not exactly lending a hand now, are you?
Harrison. Death can be tragic, death can be unfair, but as much as we may all hate to admit it, Death is inevitable. I'm merely helping fate get what it wants.
And you're telling me this because
she listens to you. And you love her. And I know that you will find a way to make her stop. Stop saving the lives of people who are supposed to die. Stop messing with fate and stop screwing with the order of the universe.
Yeah. Okay. No. No, it's okay. Don't worry, I'll take care of it. I'll be right there.
But she'll never stop.
And I'll never ask her to. So do yourself a favor, friend. You stay the hell away from me and my sister.
We're gathered here today to celebrate the union of two people, Lindsay and Randall. Two people who have found each other in a world where we rarely slow down to let ourselves be found. And to celebrate that love, the bride has asked her very good friend, True Davies, to read a passage today. True?
I carry your heart with me. I carry it in my heart. I fear no fate, for you are my fate, my sweet. I want no world for beautiful. You are my world, my true. And it's you are whatever a moon has always meant, and whatever a sun will always sing is you. Here is the deepest secret nobody knows. Excuse me, just one minute.
Your cell is off. There was no other way to reach you.
Davis, what's wrong?
Your brother, he's been shot.
We got bullet trauma, single entry. Doesn't look good. Let's set up the rapid infusers and get me a whole truckload of ONA.
Yes, sir.
Put the hole through the anterior LV. Get the thoracic surgeon on call. Stack. Okay, let's get him into trauma before he starts draining into the pleural cavity. Not a lot of time, folks.
God, Harrison. I'm his sister. What happened to him?
EMT radioed ahead. They found him in a house on Bank Street.
I'll ask. Anything happens, I promise I'll ask.
No, you are not going to die. Do you hear me? You're going to be fine.
Let us do our jobs. That's all you can do.
Harrison, he's a fighter, you know? He's gonna be okay. I'm so sorry about the wedding.
Oh, the wedding can wait. Lindsay belongs with you.
Hello, I'm looking for a patient, Harrison Davies.
Excuse me.
I'm sorry, ma'am, he's still in surgery.
Nurse's station.
I'm Harrison's sister, do you know him?
Not really, I was the one who called 911. He was shot.
You were with him?
No, I mean, it's my ex. He just gets so jealous. I am so sorry. I shouldn't have come here. I just wanted to make sure he was okay.
Your ex was who's... Wait.
Hey.
Dad.
I was in town for a meeting. They found my card in Harrison's wallet.
He's hurt, Dad. It's not good.
We don't know anything yet. I'm gonna find a doctor.
He's still in surgery. They just told me to wait here.
Okay, we'll wait.
Excuse me. Hey! I want you out of here right now. You are not welcome here.
I came to see my friend.
You had something to do with this. I know you did.
This morning, I went to your brother's place. Our conversation ended badly, so I called him to clarify. A paramedic answered the phone. I got worried.
If anything happens to him, I'm holding you responsible. Do you understand that? It is on you.
True.
True, sweetheart. They did everything that they could.
No, he can't be.
True.
Talk to me. Talk to me, Harry.
Miss, you're not supposed to be in here.
He needs me. You said. Harry. Harry, you always said you'd ask, so ask me, please. I'm right here. Harry, just ask me.
True. Sweetheart, come on.
I'll be waiting at the morgue. I won't leave you. I'm always by your side.
Good to see you, too.
I tried to reach you all morning. I called your house. I called your cell.
Oh, heavy sleep or what?
I went by your place. You weren't there.
What? Well, what's going on?
Today isn't going to be your day, Harrison.
Nah, today's the day that I'm going to be a better man. Today's the day that I'm going to...
die.
So let me get this straight. I'm dead in the hospital, and I asked for your help.
Fortunately, yeah.
Wow. Oh, so was Lindsay there?
What?
Lindsay. Was she there in the hospital?
Yeah, she postponed the wedding as soon as she heard you were shot.
Okay. That is great! Yes! So were people sad and like tears flowing and...
Harrison.
What? Well, come on. How many times does this guy get to die and come back? Set the scene for me.
Okay, I can set the scene for you or I can keep you alive. Which do you prefer?
Fine.
Okay. First of all, who were you dating?
Dating? No one.
Wrong time to be coy, Harry. There was a woman there at the hospital, said you were shot by her jealous ex on Bank Street. Do you know anyone who lives on Bank Street?
No one. Look, there's no girlfriend. There's no jealous exes. There's no Bank Street.
Are you sure it's me who asked for help yesterday?
Okay, we may not know why you were killed, but we know one thing. Your death is entirely preventable.
So let me ask you this. Scale of 1 to 10. How much weeping are we talking about here?
Harrison, everything that you did yesterday, we have to do differently today.
Okay, so where to?
The place you were least likely to be yesterday.
How can you be so sure I wasn't here yesterday?
Because the last book you read had pictures in it.
Point.
I got here as fast as I could.
Hey.
What?
I'm so sorry. Please accept my condolences. You were so young.
Dude, I'm still alive. I died yesterday.
Why don't we talk in private?
I know this one is personal, but you're doing everything right. I can't think of any reason why you can't win this one.
I can. Jack came by the hospital last night, and you don't remember me telling you this, but yesterday morning he also showed up at Harrison's apartment.
But you don't think Jack has anything to do with...
No, not yesterday, but if Jack really is my opposite, then today...
He'll do whatever he can to make sure that fate plays out the same way.
meaning it's his job to make sure Harrison dies.
Oops. Sorry.
Hello?
Well, he seems to be handling it okay.
He wanted an estimate of number of tears people shed last night in gallons.
Yeah. Okay, don't worry. I'll take care of it. No, I'll be right there. Look, this is probably something you don't want to hear, but there is someplace I need to be.
No way. Not a chance.
Look, someone's in a jam, and they need my help, okay? It's important.
No.
Probably called yesterday, too.
Who is it? And what do they want? I mean, need I remind you, you died yesterday.
All right, look, this may sound stupid, but ever since Lindsay met this Randall guy, I took stock. And I'm tired of being this screw-up. Look, there's this rec center around the corner from my place. They have all these sorts of programs for these kids. Well, the other day, I just walk in to get change for the meter, and I walk out, someone's big brother.
Who's the kid?
Ethan McCrane. Folks got divorced last year. Look, I may not know how it is to be a great dad, but I know how to survive without one. And that's Ethan on the phone, and he got busted shoplifting. He's too afraid to call his mom, so unless an adult goes down there to claim him, you know, the owner's gonna call the cops.
And where's the store?
It's on Carver and Fifth.
It's a good 3 miles from Bank Street. Yeah. Okay, you can go, but I'm coming with you.
Okay, let's go. See you, Morgan.
Are you coming?
No. Go ahead and go. There's something I need to take care of.
Okay.
You took my seat. I was sitting there yesterday.
Yeah, just to let you know that Harrison won't be showing up today.
Ah, good old True. At least he's gonna make this sporting. So why don't you tell me what you really want?
I just want to hear it for myself.
What's that?
Who you are, what you can do, how you can live with yourself.
I respect you, Davis. You're a man of science. You want answers, conclusions. So how's this? I preserve the order of the universe by ensuring the cycle of life.
Well, fate already has a representative, Jack, and it is not you.
True? Now, this is where we're going to have to agree to disagree. Because if True was serving fate, why does fate need me?
She helps people live.
Who were supposed to die. Don't you see? She can't win.
You're wrong. I've seen her save people. She can win.
Yes. You've seen her outfox killers, talk people off ledges, and quite capably, I might add. But if you think that's the end of the story, you're missing the best part.
What's that?
I think we'll save that for another time. Wouldn't want to blow on my best material at once, but it's good to see you, boss. Tell Harrison I'll catch him later.
If I see him in my place again, I'm gonna call the cops.
Yes, sir. Not a problem. Come on, buddy. Yeah. If you're hungry, you call me. But I'm like VIP at all the restaurants in town. I don't forget candy bars. I'm talking steak and tiramisu. Oh, this is my sister. She's cool. She looks out for me. Kind of how I look out for you.
Hi, Ethan.
Hi. You're not gonna tell my mother, are you?
Not a chance. You what?
What?
Yeah. We'll take you home. Where do you live?
It's just a few blocks. I can go on my own.
Come on, buddy. Just tell me where.
Fine. I live on Bank Street, but she's probably not even home from work.
Did you say Bank Street?
Yeah, 95 Bank Street.
Ethan, do you think your mom would mind picking you up at my office? Why don't you guys wait and sign in until Ethan's mom gets here?
Where are you going?
I think I hear Davis in the crypt. I'll be right back. And just do me a favor, don't play with anything.
Yeah.
I won't.
Well, I was talking to him. Davis?
Sorry if I got your hopes up. I just came by to give my 2-week notice.
Don't bother. Davis took you off payroll once we realized you were death.
I'm not death, True. I don't determine who lives or dies. It's my job
to bring a little order to the universe.
Which means today your job is to make sure my brother dies.
I take no pleasure in that.
Oh, I'm sure. Later, Jack.
What if I let him live?
For a guy who claims he isn't death, you sure talk a good game.
I like your brother. I'd hate to see him die. I'd hate to see him die. Again.
Death's top 10 come-ons. Number 10, promise to spare the life of a relative.
I also hate reliving days. I mean, the first time was kind of cool, but after that, dull as dishwater.
Number 9, bitch about the job and then invite her back to your place to see your new black robe.
You know what I hate more than anything? The way you're looking at me right now. So, I won't stand in the way of you saving Harrison.
If
you stop. The next time someone asks for your help, ignore it. If your day should rewind, have fun. But don't save the life of someone whose time is up. Think about it.
I don't have to think about it, Jack. I can save my brother and anyone else who needs me.
Is that how you think this works? When you save someone who's supposed to die, there are consequences. The universe keeps very strict accounts, True, and what you're doing is messing with the books. So, if you save Harrison, the one certainty is someone else is gonna die today. In his place.
It doesn't work like that.
I guess we'll see. 12 hours to midnight. And I'm sitting on the edge of my seat because I know someone's gonna die today. Could be anyone. Could be you.
Or you.
I guess we'll see.
I guess we will.
Say goodbye to Harrison for me. Read into that any way you'd like.
Always call me, no matter what, you understand?
Hi, I'm Harrison. I know we only spoke
on the phone, right. It's yeah. Nice to meet you. Well, what can I say? Thank you so much.
Oh, no problem.
Emma.
Hi, have we met?
No, I'm True, Harrison's sister. Hey, Harry, you want to just give us a sec?
Oh, yeah. Girl talk, dude, come on.
He worships your brother. All I've heard for the last week is Harrison this, Harrison that.
It must be really tough raising him on your own.
Yeah, his father and I split up 6 months ago. Harrison may be the first stable role model he's ever had. Not exactly Donnie's strong suit.
Being a role model?
Being stable.
Could you just excuse me one sec? Emma's got a jealous ex, but she and Harrison never even met until today. He must have taken Ethan home and...
Wrong place, wrong time, right. Well, you're doing everything you need to do, keeping Harrison away from Bank Street.
What about them?
Ah, they're safe. The only person in danger is the guy he thinks is sleeping with his ex-wife. Still couldn't hurt to keep an eye on the house.
Wait, Davis, you?
From across the street. If there's any real work to be done, I'll call you. I'm not doing that stuff. I'll see you later.
Oh, True, you were awesome. You did it, you did it. You saved me. I knew it. I always knew you could do it.
Hey, we're not out of the woods yet, huh?
Oh, come on. You said it yourself. Stay away from Bank Street and I am bullet free. So, what's next? Because I'm starving. This whole dying and coming back thing really works on my appetite.
Stop. Listen to me. Look, you don't remember yesterday. You don't have to, but I do. I stood over your body, your dead body, and I will not lose you again. Do you understand me?
Yeah. Yeah, sure, whatever.
So let's go. I'm taking you somewhere safe.
Safe? What can be safer than a morgue?
We're gathered here today to celebrate the union of two people. Lindsay.
FYI, given a choice between death and attending my ex's wedding, I might have chosen death.
And in celebration of that love, the bride has asked her friend True Davies to read for us a passage today. True?
I'll be right back.
I'll be right here.
A 100 times.
We've been divorced, what, 6 months now? You already found a replacement?
Do you know how crazy this is? How crazy you sound?
Who is he?
There's no one. I haven't been out on a date since high school, and that was with you.
Don't lie to me, Emma.
Oh, my God. Would you just stop that and put that away?
My buddy saw him.
Daddy?
Hey, Eve. I didn't know you were, Mommy and Daddy, we were just talking.
We should leave, Donnie. Now.
Yeah. Hey, look, Daddy's gonna come see you real soon, okay? I'm gonna find this guy. Don't think I won't.
Goodbye, Donnie. Hey, honey.
Watch where you're going.
Well, I know where I'm going. The question is, do you?
What the hell's that supposed to mean?
Donnie? Donnie McCrane?
Yeah.
Jack. Jack Harper, Sacred Heart Basketball League. Come on, I was the point guard. Lit up St. Anthony's for 30 points back in 91. God, don't tell me you don't remember.
Sorry, Jack? No.
Hey, I was sorry to hear about your divorce, man. Some of the guys were talking about it. Hey, I've been through it myself. It sucks, doesn't it? They leave you for some young stud and we get left paying the bills. Anyway, I was sorry to hear it, man, but keep your chin up. You're a much better looking guy than he is.
Hey, you know him? You know the guy Emma's seeing?
Know him? Oh, yeah. Not only that, I know where he is right now.
Come on, True. Come on, True. Pick up the phone. Pick it up. Come on.
Hey!
Sorry, Davis.
Give me that.
Sorry. This is between me and True.
Here is the deepest secret nobody knows. And this is the wonder that's keeping the stars apart. I carry your heart. I carry it in my heart. I was to see you.
Well, Lindsay called, and she said she hadn't heard from you all day and had a nagging suspicion her best friend was going to go stag to her wedding.
No, that's why she's my best friend. She knows what I want.
Can't be easy for him. Send Lindsay marry somebody else.
It beats the alternative.
What's that?
It's a long story.
I'm not going anywhere.
You haven't heard the story yet. Okay. I promised 2 answers. Explanations that are long overdue, so here goes. Harrison's here today because I'm saving his life.
You're saving his life?
Yesterday, he was shot. And he died, and he asked for my help, and my day restarted, and so I'm helping him, because that's what I do. I help people live who aren't ready to die. And when we were together, if I ever showed up late or ran off early or acted in some inexplicable way, it was because someone needed me, because someone needed my...
Your help.
Right. And I never told you this before because I know how it sounds, but... I can do all of those things. Every one of them.
Excuse me, everyone.
Before we move inside for dinner, I would like to make a toast to my beautiful bride, Lindsay.
Luke.
Accepted me for who I am. It made my life richer because of it. To Lindsay.
Harrison. I told you, buddy, I didn't sleep with your wife.
Yeah? That's not what I heard.
Look, I'm telling you the truth. Honest, ask anybody, ask...
Your son.
Who are you?
Someone who knows the same thing that Ethan does. My brother met your ex-wife for the first time today. You may not believe me, but you have to believe your son.
Look, you're mixed up. You're mixed up. I get it. I just had to watch the woman I love marry another man. Okay, I know how you feel, but I'm not the guy you're looking for. Honest.
You better both be telling me the truth.
It's okay. Just do me a favor and keep an eye on him. There's just one more thing I gotta do.
That's a little harsh, don't you think?
Actually, I'm not so sure it is.
Let me guess. She's in love with someone else.
I wish it were that simple.
Well, I can see you need some alone time, so I'll just...
She seems so normal at first. I mean, she's pretty and smart and... You know what? Forget it.
Hey, sorry for Brian.
Okay, no, how about this? And I can't believe I'm even repeating it. She thinks dead people talk to her. Yeah, she thinks that she...
Relives days. Yeah.
How did you know that?
She told me, too. This morning. It was a practice run for you, I think. And, yeah, it did sound crazy at first.
Yeah.
Until I got some proof. And suddenly, it didn't seem so crazy. It sounded... miraculous.
You got proof?
Oh, yeah. True sent me to talk to this woman, Emma. She lives over on Bank Street, 95 Bank Street.
And what did she tell you, Emma?
Well, I'm not really sure I can do it justice, but somehow she made everything clear. But don't take my word for it. You go talk to her yourself.
I don't know, man. Bank Street.
Yeah.
Yeah, why not? Oof. Things we do for love, huh?
No. Oh, and this Emma is a bit of an odd bird. She tends to be more talkative if you go over there without being empty-handed. You know what I'm saying? Learn from my mistake. Flowers, not candy. Women.
Great. Hey, thanks. Thanks, Jack.
Anytime. So, your brother's gonna live.
Yes, he is. No thanks to you.
Would it ring hollow to say I'm glad?
Would it ring hollow to say I don't care?
Unfortunately, someone still has to die today.
Try not to sound so broken up about it, Jack.
I'm really sorry, True. Like I said, there are parts of my job that sometimes don't make me feel so good about myself.
What did you do to him?
I didn't do anything. You did. You told him who you are. I just told him where he could get proof.
Emma. Come on, open up. Look, I'm sorry. Ethan? You guys home? Hello?
Safe. What? Can I help you?
Yeah, I'm looking for Emma.
She's not here right now. And you are?
I'm Luke.
Nice flowers. You a friend of Emma's, Luke?
No, actually, we've never even met before.
Okay, why don't we try this again, and how about the truth this time? Are you a friend of my wife's, Luke?
I think there's been some kind of mistake.
Oh, yeah. And you made it. Was it worth it? Because I know she's good, but was she really worth your life, Luke?
I understand that you're upset, sir, but I promise you, I have never met your wife before.
Then why do I see you, the two of you, in my bed? And it makes me sick. It makes me want to...
Donnie. Please, put the gun down. Just listen.
He's sleeping with her!
No, he's not. It's all a misunderstanding.
Drew, get out of here.
Donnie, please listen to me. We'll all talk
about
this.
Sorry, I can't lose
now,
Donnie.
I can handle this.
Donnie, don't do this!
Drew, get out of here! Drew, go!
I'm just so sorry.
Please. Please! Donnie, Drew. Don't do this! Drew. Please, no! Donnie, no!
I'm sorry, I didn't believe you.
No, Luke, come on, it's gonna be fine. I'm gonna get help, okay? Just stay with me. Stay with me, look at me, okay?
I love you, Drew.
No, please, 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 no, Luke. Please, just stay with me, you're gonna be fine. Look at me. Look at me, please. Luke. Luke. Luke, come on, just please don't. Don't.
Ensure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life through our Lord. We commend to Almighty God our brother, Luke Johnston, and we commit his body to the ground. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. The Lord bless him and keep him. The Lord make his face to shine upon him and be gracious unto him and give him peace. Amen.
Life. Thank you. Is there any chance that he'll ask?
Don't know. Don't think so. Wait here.
Don't, Drew. I take no pleasure from being right.
It's my turn to talk, so listen up. My mother had the calling, and she passed it on to me. If you think for one minute that I'm ever going to stop, you're wrong. So you better watch your back, buddy, because it's on.
You should know one thing. This is bigger than you think.
And you should know one thing.
You have no idea what you've begun.
Get in.
So, tell me, what does my daughter know?
Nice to see you too, Richard. Why don't I start with what she doesn't know? That you once did what I do.
She's tough. You'll have your work cut out for you. Just like I had with her mother.
You won that one, didn't you? Besides, I love a challenge.
Well, Jack, I believe you got one.